Big L was a very talented individual, you know. He was a guy with a good heart. He was a guy that had a lot of jokes and would push the buttons, you know what I'm saying? He was real creative. I mean, he had pure energy. He'd get on stage, he'd take it to the next level where it wanted to be, you know. He was a star in the making. Unfortunately, it was a short time, you know.
John Robertson. You know, when I used to come get Big L from here, I used to just come scoop him and we was off. Whatever we was gonna do, you know. Once in a hot minute, you might catch me out here for more than 15, 20 minutes, but for the most part, I used to scoop him. We just had plans all the time, you know. I wanted him off the block. I wanted him on the block and I would just pop and come up here and just chill out, but the key was to get him motivated and the key was to take him places, show him things so he would want to leave and become the dude that he can, you know?
That's a New York minute for you. That's a New York minute. That's what you see anytime. I DJed for OC and Big L. You know, we did an overseas tour for like a month or so, month and a half actually. I still got footage from that. That was a good adventure. It was everywhere. Croatia, Amsterdam, Switzerland, Germany, Japan. You know what I'm saying? I mean, overall, everything was a good adventure. L is a character, you know. He was a guy with many jokes. I was the one with many jokes, too. But he got to me a few times, and we had to battle with the jokes and all that, you know. Just good adventures. I mean, like, Croatia. That was a little bit after the war. Y'all know, we actually spoke to the promoter when he was out. He was like, yeah, like, maybe almost a year ago, they was fighting in the street. I was like, well, okay, why are we here? What are we doing here? Can we do this show? And let's go going to Amsterdam or something.
I met L on 125th Street. I was doing an autograph signing. And during me doing an autograph signing, he came in with him and his man. And he kept telling me, you know, he was nice. So, you know, I was like, yeah, all right, you know, I'm going to hook you up with my manager or whatever. And he was like, well, look, I'll tell you like this, you know. I'll rhyme for you, and if you don't like me, I won't bother you again. So, you know. Can't tell a nigga like me that. It's like, oh, word? Wow, you know, I'm looking for a reason not to like it now, but, you know, the dude was so dope. When he finished rhyming, you know, I was getting his numbers. Yeah, this was before COC. COC was created, like, after his first album.
I basically met L through Ness. You know what I'm saying? Back in the days, he was always around with him doing things. My whole little inset into DITC, it started, I met Diamond first, you know, from Diamond, and just one day they had a party at this club in the Bronx called The Castle. That's the night where I actually met Finesse, AG, Show, all in like same night, Hickory and all of them, you know, we were cool since then. That's like 1991. It's all love, you know, they came down now, they doing a memorial, doing the wall over for them. Came through with Ness, was like, let's come celebrate them, you know.
The day he was killed, it was crazy because I get a phone call. And actually, where he got killed is, he got killed down here in this block. See them big buildings? He got killed, you know, between the buildings around here. So it's not too far from where he got killed at. I remember coming out here that night, it was me, Show, and Big Fat Joe. I got a call, yeah. And when I got a call, that's when I came down here. You know, to find out he was still laying in a couple, you know?
The day he passed, I think, it was either I got the call from Buck or I got the call from Finesse and they told me what happened. And I was like, oh, that's crazy. Because at that time, I'm remembering, you know, we was all on tour. I got the videotapes of the shows and all the things. Like, man, you know, you lost another person that, you know, that was a fixture in your life, so. He's a part of the team, you know, it's a brother from another mother, and he's no longer here.
You from the hood, the project, you lose a lot of friends in different ways, you know? You know, you just, natural age is damn near non-existent in the hood and the project. I don't see a lot of too many people that die from natural causes.